Hello everyone, welcome back to the Power BI tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about the Power Queries only and how using the Power Queries can we actually work upon the data. We have seen that how can we merge the different tables into our Power Query using the Power Query Editor. So we had the data in our Excel sheet that consisted of the different tables spanning through different sheets. However, in our previous video, the data that we looked about was uniform data. Means we had three columns in all the sheets, in all the tables, that was the date, product, and the quantity columns. Okay. But now in this video, what we have done is we have somewhat changed that data. We have updated that data. We have added some columns in the data or in some tables, while some of the tables are as it is. Like if you see this January 2020 sheet is having the first table, that is table 1. It is as it is, like date, product, and the quantity columns. Then if we take a look at this February 2020 sheet, so we have added the sales column, which is showing the total sales done in that particular day. And we have added this column. So the data is different now. Okay. And similarly in the March sheet also, in the table 1, 3, 4, we have created a new column, that is of returned items, that is how many items were returned on that particular day. So this is the numerical column that we have added. Now the question is, when the tables have like different columns or the different types of columns or the different number of columns, then also is it possible for Power Query Editor to just append those tables into one another, or will it give us any kind of an error? So well, this is the question that we are going to answer in this video. So let's see its practical example. Let's go to our Power BI once again, and we are going to just import our data from Excel once again. Or what we can do is we can just import the data from Excel once again. This is quarter one data only. Let's just click on open. So it may take a few seconds to open, and you can see that we are having this sheets over here with sales data. This is the quantity, and this is with the returned items. Okay, that's the updated data, and in the tables also you can see the data has been updated. All right, so we can just select the tables which we want to import, that is these three tables we wanted to import, and let's just click on transform data. Okay, now what happens? It may take a few seconds to open it up in the Power Query Editor. Here you can see that we have table 1, that is the original one, table 1, 3, that is having the sales column, and this table 1, 3, 4, which is having this returned column. Okay, now let's see what happens if we try to just append them together. Okay, so we know that to append them, we need to go to this home tab. And here in the combined group, we have this append queries option. So we can just go to append queries as new. And okay, this dialog box is in front of us. We can click on three or more tables. We have table 1, the second instance that is already added. So we do not need to add it again. We can just add this table 1, 3 and table 1, 3, 4, all of the second instances. Okay. And then once we are happy with it, we can simply click on OK. Now let's just see what happens. Okay, so in table 1 we had the three columns. Okay, the three original columns, that was the date column, the product column, and the quantity column. Okay, the sales column was not present and the returned column was not present. So what the Power Query Editor has done is it has updated those values with null. Means whatever the number of columns is, like in the second table we had a sales column, so the sales column is added over here, and in the third column or the third table we had a new column called returned, so this returned column is also added, but only for the values that it had. Like for the March value or the March data, we had this returned value, so it is added over here, and all the rest of the values are termed as null. Similarly for the sales column also, only the February days have the data for the sales, and all of the rest of them are appended or provided with a value of null. So this is possible in Power Query Editor, that we can actually combine the data of the different columns or of the different sheets or the different columns or the different tables, and it would just append them all together and replace the values with null. So that's how we can work with it, right? Now there is one important question: is this the query named is append to? Okay, here you can see that in the property settings its name is append to. So if you want, you can just change its name to like merged columns or merged queries. Okay, so what would happen is now we would be getting our new table. This is this whole data with a name merged queries or merged table, whatever name you want to provide, you can just give it any name. Then you can just click on this close and apply option, and the changes must have been applied. Okay, so you need to just wait for a few seconds until and unless this merge table is created. So after this, there is one interesting thing to note, that we would be just getting this if you just take a look at this fields table. So let's just get rid of this table first. Okay, so here we have this merged table, and apart from this merged table, we are also having the second instance of like table 1, second instance of table 1, 3, and second instance of table 1, 3, 4. Now once we have merged the data from these three tables, we do not want this data to be visible anymore. We do not want our raw data to be visible to anyone to whom we are sharing our Power BI report. We only want the final data to be visible, because we do not want to them to know, or we do not want our clients to know that what was the original data and how we have changed it to the one that they are getting right now. So for this purpose, we only want this merged table or this append one table to be shown to the user, to the end user or to the client, and not the rest of the tables. So how can we work on that? So for this purpose, you again need to open the Power Query Editor window. Now the question is, how can you open it? So if you go to this home tab only in Power BI desktop app, you will find this queries option, and in this queries option there is this transform data option, and you can see that it would open the Power Query Editor. So we can just click on it and it would again open the Power Query Editor. Okay, now if we are talking about the merged table, now in this merged table, table 1, table 1, 3, and table 1, 3, 4, second instance was the source data. We do not want the source data, so if you want to remove the source data, in the queries pane on the left hand side, you can just right click on that particular table, and here is this option of enable load, that is shared right now, so you can just uncheck it, and basically you can just click on continue. Similarly over here also, you can click on enable load, uncheck the enable load option, and click on continue, and here also. Okay, so what would happen is, you see these three are changed to italics, which means they would not be loaded. We have unchecked the enable load option, which means they wouldn't be enabled now. Their load is not enabled, so they won't be loaded. So now if you just click on close and apply, then you can see that after a few seconds, after it's been applied, the changes have been applied, you would be able to see that this merged table is only present and the second instances are no longer present. Why? Because we have changed it. Okay, now one important thing to note, if we just get our table over here, and if we try to just view this table append one, so we are getting only these three columns. Okay, but if we are getting this merged table, so we are getting these five columns over here. But if we just take a look at table 1 or table 1, 3, so you can see they have not been updated. Although we have made some changes into our Excel sheet, but this table 1, 3 or table 1, 3, 4 have not been updated. Okay, so if you want them to update, you can just go to this queries option, the home tab, the queries option, and can click on refresh. So what would happen when you're trying to do that is, the connection would be established with the original Excel sheet from where you have got the data. And now you can see that in table 1, 3, we are getting the sales column, and in table 1, 3, 4, if you see, we are getting this returned column. Similarly, in this appended query also, we are getting this returned and the sales column as it is. Why? Because we have made some changes. We have refreshed the changes as per our Excel sheets in Power BI. So in order to work with data like this, you can simply click on refresh and all of your data would be refreshed automatically. And that is the power of using the relationships, because Power BI creates a connection with your Excel workbook or whatever the data you have provided. It does not copies the data, it just loads the data as a part of a connection. It establishes a link. So whenever you try to click on refresh, all of your data would be updated as per the changes that you have done in your original data source. So this is all for this video. Thanks for watching.